Demaratos. Porphyry, the Neoplatonist, in pedagogic mode, proposed that his pupil, a young sophist, should prepare an outline of the character of the deposed king of Sparta, Demaratos. The sophist produced this precis in preparation for a later speech. Demaratos was at the court of Darius, then, when Darius died, became attached to the circle of his son, the warlike Xerxes, Persian king. With Xerxes and his mighty army, he seeks his vindication and quietus. Who could blame him? The Spartans well and truly stitched him up. He had to grant them that. Was he not King Ariston's lawful son? The traitors bribed the Delphic Oracle to declare him illegitimate, a lie. Not satisfied with slander, deposition, they subjected him to gross humiliation. No wonder he welcomed a situation at the opposing belligerent Persian court. That made him a traitor too. Oh yes, he knew. Of that he was too painfully aware. Nonetheless, he's happy with King Xerxes. He'll follow the Persian armies into Sparta, regain his rightful place, be recrowned king. When he rules once more, he'll make damn sure the vermin Leotychides, most arch of all arch enemies, is satisfactorily expelled, shamed, and expelled. Anticipating this, he's on the razor's edge in his efforts to ensure the Persian king should conquer and subdue the whole of Greece. Brain work and brain ache harry Demaratos, darken his impatient waiting days. He knows he should be contented, but he can't. The thought of revenge awaiting his firm grasp feels his fingertips tingling in expectation, is blanked out by the growing realization he really can't shake off this grim conclusion that after all, the Greeks will be triumphant.